As we promised that, we are going to speak about a very important issue, which is global change and water shortage. We are talking about global issues which are facing the whole world. Egypt is part and parcel of our planet, and we do have a lot to do to face these challenges, or these threats to be accurate. What are we doing to face this? What are we doing to guarantee that the coming generations are not going to suffer from water shortage? All these questions and more, we are going to have an expert who is going to answer all these questions. We are very much delighted and honored to have with us Engineer Mayeda Mohammed Anwar, Deputy Manager in the Egyptian Public Authority for Drainage Projects, Ministry of Water Resources and Irrigation. A very good morning to you, ma'am.
Good morning.
Good morning, ma'am. And let's clarify the main water resources in Egypt in a very clear way.
Well, first let me highlight that Egypt water resources are the main pillar for water security, for national security. And the Egypt share for non-water is 55.5 billion cubic meter per year, mm-hmm. according to agreement with Sudan in 1959. And this Nile water resource represents 98% of renewable fresh water. Due to water scarcity and population increase to more than 104 million capita, Egypt is widely practicing reusing of drainage water. Mm-hmm. So the reusing of drainage water reaches now 13.5 billion cubic meter per year. Mm-hmm. Other water resources as shallow ground water, deep ground water, desalination, and rainfall and flash flood. Mm-hmm. But let me talk briefly about what we call Egypt water footprint. Mm-hmm. The total water demand in Egypt is about 114 billion cubic meter per year. And the imported virtual water, which is coming from imported fruits, vegetables, and meats, 34 billion cubic meter per year. Mm-hmm. And the total available water from Nile River, from rainfall, and desalination is 59.25. So the remaining water gap is 21 billion cubic meter per year. Mm-hmm. This gap is closed by using of the drainage water and using of shallow groundwater.
Then, among the strategies implemented by the Ministry of Water Resources and Irrigation is the reuse of the drainage water.
Yes.
But especially in what? I mean, in the field of agriculture, for example,
yes.
in agriculture only, in industry, and for example, to fill this gap of the factories which need water.
Mainly the reuse of drainage water is used for agricultural purposes, as we agriculture consumes about more than 85% of our water resources.
I mean, in the delta, in the desert,
yes.
especially in certain places,
in
according to certain weather, for example, what?
Yes, we are reusing the drainage water for cultivation, especially in Nile Delta regions,
mm-hmm.
and also in Sinai. We have two mega projects, Mahsama project to transfer about 1 million cubic meter per day,
mm-hmm.
To east of Sinai to reclaim about 60,000 fedan,
mm-hmm.
and also for Bahr al-Bahr drain we transfer 5 million mm-hmm. cubic meter to reclaim 230,000 fedan.
Mm-hmm. Could you please talk about the Cairo Water Week main themes and its side events?
Yes, let me highlight that Cairo Water Week provided an excellent platform for exchanging experiences, knowledge, and study cases and success stories. We have five main themes in Cairo Water Week, mm-hmm. starting with the name of Cairo Water Week, which is water management for sustainable development,
mm-hmm.
Climate change and environment, transboundary water governance and benefit sharing, water scarcity, health and sanitation, challenges and opportunities, science, technology, and innovation.
Mm-hmm.
And during Cairo Water Week, there were a lot of high-level events.
Mm-hmm.
The first, talking about the main event, which is the high-level ministerial meeting for international Islamic cooperation. Consists of 57 countries, the fourth session of Islamic Conference, and also the third ministerial meeting for Delta Coalition, which consists of 13 countries,
mm-hmm.
among them Egypt, France, Japan, Indonesia, and deal with integrated management and sustainable development of deltas and cover number of themes as the coastal management regions and also financing climate adaptation projects. And the chairmanship handed over from Egypt to Japan, next chair. Now we can talk about an important event during Cairo Water Week, which is the first Young Water Professional Forum. Under umbrella of International Commission for Irrigation and Drainage, and consists of 12 countries with 24 participants. And I were lucky to be one of these participants. Three-day workshop during Cairo Week aimed at building capacity of new professionals and also new generation of leaders which can deal with and capable of dealing with water future challenges. Also the fourth steering committee meeting for establishing navigational line between Lake Victoria and Mediterranean Sea project.
This is what I wanted to ask about, because of course this is great to find Western countries like Germany, to have Asian countries like Indonesia, but I think in my humble opinion Africa is the most important partner.
Yes.
Africa is our strategic depth.
Yes.
And when it comes to Egypt, Egypt is the Nile is Africa.
Yes.
For example, we were very happy to know that the Tanzanian president was keen to phone President Abdel Fattah al-Sisi and to invite him.
Yes.
To be there in the inauguration ceremony or having the stone of the new dam there, which is going to be constructed by Al-Muqawlun al-Arab or the Arab contractors.
Yes.
Of Egypt. I'd like to know more about the cooperation and coordination between Egypt and the African countries in this file, water resources and water shortage.
Yes, the cooperation between all Nile water basin in all fields of water resources and using water resources in many fields like agriculture, industry, and
electricity.
Household electricity, and many cooperation between Egypt and all countries in Nile Basin especially.
Right, could you please talk to us about your poster presentation?
My poster presentation during the week is the drainage water use plan, which is in line with our national plan. Our ministry together with other ministries have formulated the National Water Resource Plan 2037. Mm-hmm. With objective to support socio-economic development in Egypt with the basis of sustainable resource use.
Mm-hmm.
With two approaches: to develop additional resources and making better use of existing resources.
Mm-hmm.
So drainage water use is one of the measures which accelerate effective use of existing resources.
Mm-hmm.
And our plan have main four main objectives, starting with enabling environment and improve the water quality, enhance the fresh water availability, and also improve management of water use.
Mm-hmm.
Now we can start talking about the project. The project study area mainly in Kafr Sheikh.
Mm-hmm.
We implement the project in five sites in Kafr Sheikh, three in East Kafr Sheikh and two in West Kafr Sheikh. And this project talking about the use of drainage water.
Mm-hmm.
From upstream to downstream, how we start with water control, then water treatment, and ending with water use. And we have two categories: wide area application and irrigation complex.
Mm-hmm.
Start talking about wide area application, how to improve the water quality of Gharbaya drain.
Mm-hmm.
Along Gharbaya drain, there were large small villages and hamlets.
Mm-hmm.
And people in small village and hamlets dump their sewage water directly into the drain.
Mm-hmm.
But in large villages, people, their sewage
Sinister
water...
in the Qahlaya, by the way.
Yes.
Mm.
The sewage water were collected by tractor and thrown to the nearby drains into Gharbaya drain.
Mm-hmm.
But the most the major source of pollution in Gharbaya drain is El Mahalla Kobra City wastewater treatment facility.
Mm-hmm.
And this facility is serving 440,000 capita in year 2006.
Mm-hmm.
With a capacity of 90,000 cubic meter per day for both domestic and industrial wastewater.
Mm-hmm.
And serving El Mahalla Kobra city and eight villages around the city.
Mm-hmm.
But due to population increase and deterioration of the facility,
mm-hmm.
the facility can't meet the demand. The operation is only one shift from 6 a.m. till 2 p.m., which means that it stopped till the following morning. Then the sewage water dumped directly into Gharbeya drain. Gharbeya drain not only suffering from sewage water, but also suffering from high salinity due to its very near to Mediterranean Sea. And this salinity is very harmful to soil and crops, and will increase by time due to increase of the water level in Mediterranean Sea caused by climate change. The second component in wide area application, talking about reuse pump station. What's the criteria for choosing when to implement small or large scale reuse pump station? For example, if we have a drain with a wide cross section area, and hence the amount of collected drainage water is large, and the canal running near is small, so it's more relevant to construct a small scale reuse pump station at the branch level. But if we have a small drain crossing a canal like Mitiazit Canal, which is one of the main canals in Kafrsheikh, so it's more possible to construct large scale use pump station at a crossing point. The move talk about renewable the drain by using box culvert, or what we call a covering drain. Years ago, we have a study called the covering agricultural drain in residential area in Egypt. By PCM in year 2005. And in this study, three cover drains were selected: field assessment, environmental assessment, social and social survey, and economical and financial study. And as a result, covering drain doesn't completely solve the problem. It either goes by it upstream or downstream or both. And the maintenance of covering drain is very difficult, leading to blockage, flies and mosquitoes. But due to social surveys, the overall perception of the residents there, they stated that it's positive. They, it eliminates offensive odors, prevent children from passing on the drains, and also increase width of the streets. But they are willing to pay for waste management rather than covering drain. Also, we talk about effective monitoring for water quality. In our ministry, we have DRI, Drainage Research Institute, measures the water quality of the major drains in Egypt, and published the result of this measurement as the water status in the Nile Delta Yearbook. And the main priority for setting a water conservation plan is to determine the main pollution in the drain, to set priority of implementation, and to identify the pollution either from waste or from agricultural waste, or this pollution come from the source. So different countermeasures will be applied for each.
CSR. Corporate social responsibility, because all what you're saying will not be implemented except with the fruitful cooperation between you as a ministry and between the Ministry of Industry and Trade from one side, which is also a governmental issue, a governmental in another in governmental institute, and the private sector. Because if the factor is whether affiliated to the public sector or the private sector are not cooperating well with what you're saying, it's not going to work.
That's what I recommend at the end of my poster presentation. This is only one issue I want to add to what the area application, which is effective use of drainage water for crop production by reducing chemical fertilizers. And here we talk about the drainage water is very essential for crops. It contains nutrients, which is very important for crops and soil, can be utilized as fertilizers. And you have a manual or guideline for using chemical fertilizer together with using drainage water. And this manual should be extended to farmers who are practicing drainage water use. Talking about irrigation complex and this what we implement in our project, starting with the composting system, environmental campaign, an environmental campaign the residents are willing to make anything for garbage collection system, and also constructing of in-stream treatment facility inside the drain. This in-stream treatment something like hyacinths, for example, inside the drain, which minimize the load or pollution load before entering the wastewater treatment facility. Constructing rural sewage system, and here's the rule of concerned party is Ministry of Housing. And also the reuse pump station, and here's the rule of concerned party is our ministry through mechanical and electrical department. And organizing farmer organization by strengthening water user association. It's very important to transfer gradually management to farmers themselves, how to operate, how to manage the facility. Finally, we have to say that in irrigation complex, all components are combined with some of them to implement according to circumstances of the target area. But in wide area application, each component could be implemented intermittently. And what are the outputs of irrigation complex? It increases the water use for agriculture, increase crop productivity, decrease conflict among farmers, and decrease the diseases. It's a very important project. And we can talk about what the role of IPAD during implementation of the project. IPAD is part of our ministry. It play a very important and central part for implementation and coordination among Ministry of Housing, Ministry of Environment, Ministry of Agriculture, and Ministry of International Cooperation. Some recommendation for this project is how to sustainability of the project. And this sustainability can't come without coordination. We need coordination among all stakeholders from central level to village level. And also we need to make a protocol between our ministry and Ministry of Housing for small use wastewater treatment facilities. Also, we need to organize farmer organization and strengthening water user association for transferring, for management of the facilities, for operation, for maintenance. And we didn't stop at that point, but we made a master plan for all Kafr Sheikh. And in order to make this plan, we need to identify and manage the possible sites to construct an irrigation complex. So GIS map have been prepared with layers of drains and canals and villages using topographic map of Kafr Sheikh. And the potential site where the canal and drain are close to each other. 89 sites were selected and by field survey, and the site where the water quality is not suitable were excluded.
The model, and this model is going to be implemented in other cities across Egypt, whether in the Delta or in Upper Egypt.
Right. Let's talk about the expand of population that is that comes also with pollution. The more we expand in population, the more our usage of on earth, and the more our usage of water comes problems like mainly pollution. So how could we root out problems like pollution in the time that we're living, especially that our intake of water is increasing?
Yes, we need to reduce all pollution load. What pollution load we had? We had pollution load in industrial pollution load, so we need to increase the capacities of industrial wastewater treatment facility, safe handling and disposal of industrial effluent, and raise efficiency and monitoring of industrial effluent. Also, how to reduce domestic pollutants, and this by increased coverage with wastewater treatment facility and solid management. Also to reduce agriculture waste and agriculture wastes, and this through prevent water cage fish culture in freshwater courses, and also to prevent import and produce and use of agrochemicals. Also, we need to improve the drainage water quality, and this comes through developing in stream treatment.
Well, Engineer Mayada Muhammad Anwar, Deputy Manager in Egyptian Public Authority for Drainage Projects, Ministry of Water Resources and Irrigation, thank you very much for your input.
Thank you. With pleasure. Thank you.
By this, we come to the end of this episode of Our Breakfast. So, can you meet again sometime on MAATV International? Many thanks for watching. We are in the company of Wazir Kudi, Dina Hussain, and myself, Yermin Abdurrahman. Thank you, Dina.
My pleasure, Nermin.
tomorrow is another day with another crew. Stay tuned only on Nancy Lee's International on Screen.